When it comes to the shaping function in shader, I prefer the sine way to the others, and the main reason is the easing principle. It's one of the 12 animation principles which any animator must know. These principles are the backbone of the motion, described with details in the famous book The Illusion of Life, which comes from a famous animation studio as well, the one and only Disney. These are the four key takeaways. Shader graph is a great visual tool to generate the shader code. And when it comes to mixing, blending, think about the lerp node. When the values are not in the valid range, think about the remap node to scale the shaping function. Thirdly, consider to adjust your shader to adapt with many situations. No pain, no gain. Finally, pack your shader graph like a preset gift, because you in the future might be the receiver of that gift or any other game dev roles. I've introduced a mathematical node, which is a multiply node, and you can self-study about other mathematical nodes as well, like add, subtract, divide, and modulo, where modulo node returns the remainder of the division, and the divide node calculates the division itself. Try to tell the difference between the divide and modulo nodes, because they will be used for many tiling effects like on the screen. For your curiosity, in the next video, I'm use the add node, so study about it. Remap is freaking powerful, flexible, and you might see it regularly in shader. In some cases, mapping between number ranges could be simplified and optimized by some other nodes like clamp, saturate, minimum, or maximum. And you can find out more details about them on the shader graph menu page, or you can do experiments yourself. The sine wave could be your new best friend in shader, but it's not the only shaping function in the shader graph. You might want to check out the sorted wave and the triangle wave as well. For an infinite loop 360 degree rotation motion, I prefer the sorted wave to the sine wave. Figure out the reason yourself. In fact, the triangle wave could be used to control the mixing factor very well. But the main reason I picked the sine wave is the easing principle. It's one of the 12 animation principles which any animator must know. These principles are the backbone of the motion, described with details in the famous book The Illusion of Life, which comes from a famous animation studio as well, the one and only Disney. Check out the other 11 principles yourself. We'll be right back.